This week's parasha, Parashat Kedoshim, is one of the most special parashiot in the whole Torah, because it was said in the presence of the whole Jewish people, Bahakel, as one congregation. Why? Because most of the laws and the most important fundamental laws of the Torah are expressed in this week's parasha. One very central verse is Lo teilech rachil be'amecha, lo ta'amod adam le'echa ani Hashem. You shall not walk tale-bearing, gossiping, speaking evil words in your people, and you shall not stand over the blood of your friend. I am Hashem. What does not standing over the blood of your friend mean? It means not to stand back and to see a friend, a fellow, in danger, as though someone is drowning in the river, and you don't immediately, spontaneously, out of your identity and love and concern for your friend, jump into the river in order to save his life. If a person just stands on the bank of the river and doesn't jump into the river, he performs one of the most severe offenses in the whole Torah. That's this verse, Lo ta'amod adam le'echa. We have to make every possible effort to save another Jew, another friend in mortal danger. Why do these two things go together? These two averot, transgressions. They're both in one verse. If they're both in one verse, it means that they interrelate. They're interdependent. Don't speak bad words about other people. And don't stand back and not save another person's life if you are able to save his life. One explanation says that even though it's forbidden for me to speak evil of another person, but if in certain exceptional contexts it's necessary to warn someone else that I heard that someone was planning evil for you, in that context, not only is it permissible to warn the other person, meaning to speak bad about someone else, because I heard someone else planning to kill you, I must immediately go and tell that person and warn him of this imminent danger. So that's one simple reason that is given why these two offenses go together. Because in general, I cannot speak bad about another person, but if it's in order to save someone else's life, then I have to speak bad about another person. That's explaining the juxtaposition of these two offenses in one direction. What about the other direction? It says deep down that the reason that a person speaks evil of another person is because he really doesn't care for that other person at all. Otherwise, he wouldn't be gossiping and just telling, be a tale bearer, telling stories about him. It means that in a certain way, he's aloof, he's separate from the other, but doesn't identify with that other person. If the other person would be so close to him that he touches him as myself, he wouldn't go around gossiping about him. So, because a person gossips about other people, it means that he sets himself off in a way and disregards actually the honor of other people, and that itself will bring him to the offense of standing aside and just looking, say, at someone drowning in the river, chas v'shalom, God forbid, and not spontaneously, because of identity, jumping into the river to save his life. Let's try to make this even more pertinent and simple. There are some people, we'll call them reporters, like a newspaper writer. He reports events. So deep down, a gossiper, or just saying bad words about people, even though he's not trying to say just bad things, but his attitude towards life and his attitude towards society is the attitude as of a reporter. If a person is a reporter, he's not going to spontaneously jump into the river to save somebody else from drowning, because his mentality is one of a report. He reports events. He doesn't take part of the event itself. But what the Torah wants to impress upon us very, very deeply, that in this world, in this life, we're not meant to be reporters. We're meant to be part, and an explicit part of the picture and part of the people. And all Jews have to feel identified with one another, one and the same, in equality. And that will prevent us, that rectified mentality and rectified state of consciousness will prevent us both from just going around gossiping and also prevent us from just standing aside and looking at something happen and not spontaneously feeling that I must jump in, even according to some opinions, even to endanger myself in order to save my friend from imminent danger.